Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the Firefly for Great Indian Bustard. So there has been a very innovative solution proposed by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change along with the Wildlife Conservation Society to help the Great Indian Bustard, or what you might have even heard of as Son Chiraiya. So this particular bird has become critically endangered over a period of time, and in fact, if you have been following news and if you have been following news properly, you would have heard about that the UNCCD, which was held in India, which is United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, over there Prime Minister has actually talked about how desertification has led to the extinction of few species, and this include actually along with the cheetah, pink-headed duck, it also included the Great Indian Bustard. So this is the context, so you can understand that the Great Indian Bustard in India has, their population has really dwindled. So this innovative advancement or this innovation is going to really help these birds to don't get entangled with the power line. So this is the main purpose. So let's go ahead and try to see. So Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change along with Wildlife Conservation Society. So just remember, Wildlife Conservation Society is an NGO working in the US. So just remember this, this is enough for it. So along with the Wildlife Conservation Society and the Union Ministry of Environment in India has come up with a unique initiative of Firefly Bird Diverter for overhead power lines in areas where Great Indian Bustard population are found in the wild. So wherever the Great Indian Bustard, for the easy we were going to call them GIB, wherever they are found in India in wild, the power line. So we know that you must have seen how the power lines are like established in India. So what happened when they are like going on a flight, these birds are very heavy. So just remember, these are very heavy birds. So when they are in flight and trying to go across, at times they get entangled in these power lines and they are not able to divert it because they are very heavy. So in like on the flight, they cannot just turn and twist. So because of their sheer weight, they are not able to do it. So what this particular initiative is going to do, it is going to act as a diverter. So there will be like light around these power lines so that the GIB, when they are in flight, they are going to see them like from 50 meter. So they can again kind of ignore them. So this is going to be a Firefly bird diverter. So this is the major understanding or major idea of having this initiative. So from this perspective, let's just try to understand where the GIBs are found. So this is the bird, if you see over here. So this has become critically endangered now. This is like really critically endangered, and if not proper measures are taken, it will really become extinct. So these are generally found in the flat open landscape with minimal visual obstruction and disturbance, therefore adapt well in grasslands. So where they are generally found in dry grasslands. Which are the places in India where these grasslands are found? Majorly in Rajasthan. So Great Indian Birds are majorly found in Rajasthan, and in fact there is a project for the conservation of Great Indian Project, which is right now Project Great Indian Bustard, which is now being undertaken in the Rajasthan. So that is there to provide them with conservation. It's more along the line that under the Project GIB, they will be providing them with a suitable situation for the breeding. So that is the idea of the Project Great Indian Bustard. Its population is confined mostly to Rajasthan and Gujarat, because we just saw that they prefer grassland as their habitat. So again, Gujarat and Rajasthan going to be their main state where they are found. Some small population are also found in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. So in like small population or in scattered population, they are also being sighted in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. But this is their native area. So you can understand, again, their geographical distribution is confined to a particular area. That is again one of the reason why they have become critically endangered. So these are the biggest details that you should know. So conservation status, we just talked about that the IUCN Red List put them under the critically endangered, which means their population has become very less. Again, in the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, they are placed under the Appendix 1, which means that they are again considered endangered for trading also. So there is a monitoring system on international trade. So there, over there, they are not allowed to be traded internationally, apart from the cases where they are like for scientific study or something. Apart from that, no trade is allowed for the Great Indian Bustard. In our Indian Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, they are also placed under the Schedule 1, which means they enjoy the highest protection. So this is also something that you need to know. Then very recently, the Great Indian Bustard has also been included in the Appendix 1 of the UN Convention on Migratory Species. So there is a UN Convention on Migratory Species which talk about not only avian but terrestrial and aquatic also. So just remember, the CMS, Convention on Migratory Species, is also talked about apart from avian, aquatic and terrestrial. And in this particular convention also, they have been placed under the Appendix 1, which means again, they are the species which has to be protected across their range by various countries. So protected across the range. So that is the meaning of being put under the Appendix 1, that the countries are obligated in the entire range of their migration that they will provide them with the highest of protection. So this is something about the conservation status. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.